Hello there! In this episode, you will see me how I will mount on this BMW F25 a dash cam system with front and rear view camera. And here I have the camera system. This is the wiring for powering the system. This here is a camera kit, include the front and rear camera. Here I have the front camera. This is the rear camera. Here I have a SD card, user manuals, plastic tool for removing plastic stuff from the car, some plastic clips, double tape, the cable between the front and rear camera, I will use this, USB cable for your desktop computer, this one is a SD card reader for your desktop computer, and here I have a powering supply cable, but I won't use this one because I have this one. I will mount the camera here on the windshield near rear view mirror. I will go with the cables behind the headliner, behind the A-pillar cover and down. I will take power supply from the CIS module, and with the cable from the rear view camera I will go down and up in the rear to the rear window for the rear camera. My next step is to disassemble some parts here. I will start with the sun visor. Here I have a T20 screw. Here I have this plastic caps. I need to unplug the sun visor, the switch for the light. I will put this aside. Next step with the blade, old knife. I will remove this from here, like so. To remove this module from here with the switches and the light, I need this plastic tool. And from inside here I have some clips. One here, one here. And in front here I have two metal clips. And after that I can remove it. These are the two clips from the front. And this one, you need to push it like so. And another one here. To remove the A-pillar cover, it's very simple. You will pull this cover towards the headliner, like so. It will get out from here. Next step, you will pull it towards the passenger side. Sometimes it's a little bit harder because it's a metal clip here. And after that, you can remove it. You can see here, this is the metal clip, this one. And you need to remove these two clips from here. One and the second one. And don't forget to put them back on the pillar cover. One here and one here. Next step is to remove this panel from here. Like so. Easy peasy. After that I need to remove this cover from here. This one have two screws, T25, one here, one there. next step, I have some clips, these ones. I will pull towards the back this panel. I have to unplug the light and the emergency speaker, and I can remove this panel now. Next step, I need to remove this panel, but to remove this panel, I need to remove this ornament from here. To do this, I need to take it out, you see, from inside here. Pull straight up. And this have these clips, one have remained here, this one. You have this lip here, you see it? This one will catch here. Next, with the Phillips screwdriver, remove the screw from the handle that opened the bonnet, like so. And I have here another screw, the same Phillips type. And now I'm able to remove this panel. The same, I need to pull it like so. Next, unplug the switch for the trunk lid open. This one have these clips, one here that will catch in one hole here, and this one here that will catch in this hole. And down here we'll have this thing that will be this way. Here you can see the light module. Okay, now I need to remove the rear seat. I need to pull very hard up. We'll have that clip in that area and this one here. After that, I need to remove this part from here. To do this, I need to pull down the rear seat, put my hand in here and pull towards me and up. I have here a clip that is missing. I have supposed to have here a clip, but it's missing. And this one, and this one. Now I can remove this cover from here. I have here a small clip. And these clips, one have remained here. Here. The same, this ornament will have this lip here that will catch here on the B pillar cover. This one. And now I need to remove the B pillar cover. To remove this one, I need first to remove this one. It's very easy to remove it. I have these two clips. And next step, the lower part, the same. I need to pull it towards the passenger side. And voila, we have these 4-6 clips. One have remained in here. This one. And I'm almost done. All this work for one wire, but I need to put the wire near the original harness of the car. All this for a safe installation of the system. If you will try to squeeze the wire between these plastic trims, you will not be able to know what will happen with the wire in the future. From the vibration, it's possible that somewhere the wire will be cut by the plastic or by the metal of the car. And in the good scenario, the system won't work. In the bad scenario, your car will catch fire. And now inside the trunk. Now I will need to remove this cover from here. Be careful. This one have these clips. I need to remove this cable protector from here, like so, because my wire will come from the front, will go up in here through this cable protection and up in this area. And we'll go out, and somewhere in this area I will mount the camera on the rear window. And now I'm over with the disassemble. The cable will start from here, will go through here, will go in this area, down through here. The power supply will be taken from here, from the CIS module, and the other cable will go here, down here. You can see the original wiring from the car to this area. Look, the wiring will come in here. You see it near the original wiring. Will go inside the trunk. Will exit through here. From here, will go up through this cable protection. And from this cable protection, we'll exit inside the trunk lid. The next step is to prepare the wiring. Here on this connector says connect to the rear camera. This connect to the front camera, okay. I will wrap up the cable in cloth tape. I have here two types of tapes. The both are from Tessa. I will use this one. They are a different texture. This one is look-alike with the original wiring harness from the BMW factory on this year, on this car. But BMW have used this type and this type, depending of the years of the cars. Next, I will measure to see how much I will need to wrap up these cables together. And I will have something from here to here, from here to here, and this. I will make a sign here, like so. I'll put the rear camera cable next to the power supply cable, and from somewhere around here I will start to wrap up these cables. I am doing this for two reasons. First reason is to blend the wiring with the original car harness. And the second one is to protect these wires. And I have arrived to my mark here. From here I will start to wrap up only the rear camera cable to the end. And finish my wire harness, it's protected. Now I will start to route the wire on the car. First I need to remove some clips from here. This one and this one. And now I have the headliner loose. I will take the end of the wire with the two plugs for the supply and rear camera. And I will put them in this area. Now I can put back these two clips. And I can mount back the light and the switches. First, we'll put back this end and we'll clip it back. Perfect. And the last step. Nice. I need to put the wire here in this area to be far from the airbag. For this, I will remove this cap from here and another one from here. These two small caps. And I will use some BMW clips for harness. I will use some soft tape. Like so, one and the second one, this will be here and the second one will be down there. And this will not go anywhere. Now it's perfect. It's like from the factory. Okay, I have come with the wire to here. Inside here, one wire with the power supply will come here.
Because the wire will be connected here on the CIS module. This one, and the second one is this one. It will go in this position behind the OBD socket, OBD plug. We'll go down, we'll enter here, like so. Okay, now I will start to prepare my wiring. First thing first, I need to add some fuses. Okay, now we have yellow and red with red, and I think this long it's fine. Okay, what I'm seeing here is that someone have done something to these wires. Maybe this car have in the past some GPS tracker or something similar. And this one is ignition. Here the wiring is very simple. We have ground, permanent supply, 12 volts and ignition switch. Okay, now I'm able to make a test to see if the connections are correct. the system have started. And it's working. He asked me for the SD card. Okay. Stop screaming. Perfect. It's working fine. Now I will need to reassemble everything, cleaning of course, and reassemble the car. And everything is perfect. The system have two fuses here for protection. They are 5 amps each, and everything is perfect now. What the? Look here, how much dust. Yeah. I'm almost done.
And now I will need to permanently mount the camera on the windshield, but I need to be careful on the sun visor. And what I can see, the sun visor, it's ending somewhere around this area. Something like that. You can see the sun visor, it's ending right there. Now I will need to find the best area for this camera. But first I will clean the windshield with some alcohol. And I will be careful to align the camera to be perfectly underneath the sun visor. Something like that. And now here in the back, the same, I will clean the window. This system have Wi-Fi. And because of that, it's easy for me to align the camera on the window. Now, I need to change the tactics. Okay, now let's see. Oh. Unfortunately, wherever I put the camera sees one of this line for defrosting. And this is the final position of the camera, and this is from inside. The camera is very small and discreet here on the windshield. You can see this is the front camera, this is the rear one. And here are both cameras. This is a very nice setup. The negative side of this type of camera is you cannot adjust the camera to see left or right, the front one and the rear one. This one have only to adjust it on the height. The second part is the cable for the rear camera. It's short. This cable was made to, I think, was made to mount it on the headliner. But here in the headliner, we have a big airbag and it's not safe to put the cable here. It's not safe at all to put the cable here. And from the factory, how BMW will mount this type of cameras, because BMW have their own camera, that camera will be mounted how I mount this one. If I want to mount this one how it was supposed to be mounted, the camera not in the driver area but in the passenger area, the cable will be too short for the rear camera. This is the problem with this system. The cable for the rear camera, it's a little bit shorter. If it was with I don't know, a foot longer, it was perfect. And finally, this car is ready, have a new dashcam system with two cameras. Everything was perfect. The only problem was the short cable for the rear view camera, but I have managed to resolve that problem.
In a second, I'll show you the pinout for the CIS module and the wiring route for this type of dash cams system for BMW. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing. Until next time, you know the drill. Stay awesome. Bye now.